So FR units, what the heck is FR? An FR unit stands for fraction. It's taking the space that's available and it's splitting it up among all of the things that are labeled with FR units. So here's an example. This is the kind of layout that we've done quite a lot in the last several years. We just want to take the space and make three columns, make three boxes, and make each box the same size as each other. It's not very interesting, but it's very utilitarian. We need to know how to do this using CSS Grid. So, okay, well, in the float-based world, we'd sort of go, okay, I got to set some widths on things. I'm going to float them. They need to have widths. Same thing with Flexbox world. 33%, 33%, 33%, right? That's going to make it, oh, right. But it's not really 33%. It's 33.3333%. How many decimal points do I need? There's actually been quite a few blog posts written about how many decimal points do we need to use in our fraction-based percent unit. It just feels like a lot of time wasted debating, testing browsers, thinking about something that, ugh. But the other thing is, 33.3333%, right, there's no gaps. That just means each box is going to take up the whole width. So, okay, that's not what we want. What we want is some space between our boxes. So let's set that space to 2%. So what is the number that we need to set the width to? Okay, well, let's get out some basic algebra. All right, so 32%. Oh, it's not even a decimal point anymore. Okay, but you know what? 2% is a really narrow gap, especially when the screen is narrow. 2% of a small screen is really narrow. So what if we said it's a 3%? Oh, I've got to redo all our math again, get out a post-it note, and like calculate it. But you know what? On bigger screens, 3% is really too wide. I don't want kind of a really wide percent. Well, I'll split the difference, 2.5%. So, okay, now the width of each box is 31.666%. Like, the number of the devil. This is just so much work, and all we're doing is three columns. What about four columns? What about five columns? And what I really want to do is set my gaps to be 2M. I'd like to set it based on the typography, based on the layout. I'd like the space between my boxes to always be the same, no matter how big the viewport is. How do I calculate the percent size of the box at that point? Well, it's got to be decided in the browser at runtime after the viewport is loaded, after the viewport width is known, and we got to use calc to do that. So there's the formula for calc. But that formula only works if we have three columns. What about when we have more columns at different breakpoints, right? We're going to do all this math and all these breakpoints and all this. It's just to do a simple column layout. So what have we been doing to solve this problem? We've been doing this. We've been using Bootstrap. This is why we're using frameworks like Twitter Bootstrap or like Foundation or any of the other kind of downloadable, prefabricated layout frameworks that especially even come with some like pre-made layouts. It's almost like painting by numbers. You just pick a layout off the shelf and you just use that for your content. Doesn't matter what your content is. Doesn't matter what your brand is. Doesn't matter what the voice and tone for your project is. Just whatever. Use the same layouts that everybody else is using. Part of the reason we've been doing that is because this math is such a pain. You know what we can do instead? We can use CSS Grid. And in the world of CSS Grid, we don't need to calculate what those percents are going to be. We're not going to use percents at all. We're going to say, I want my gaps to be 2M, and then I want each of these columns to be 1FR. One fraction for you, one fraction for you, one fraction for you. And then the browser is going to do all the math. It turns out that computers are really good at doing math. We can let them do this basic algebra. So in this example, you can see, okay, well, when I have three columns, 1FR plus 1FR plus 1FR, the browser adds that up. That's 3FR total. And so therefore, each 1FR means it gets 1/3 of the total space. Or here, the moment we suddenly have four columns, we can still assign 1FR to each of those columns. We don't have to change the percent or anything. So we actually frequently don't even need to add breakpoints to change the number, the widths of each column. We can just say 1FR. And in this case, the moment that there's four columns, the browser understands that that means that now there's four total. And so each one of them is going to get 1/4 of the space. This is also why we're able to mix in grid fixed width columns or rows with flexible columns or rows. We can say I want the very first column to be 100 pixels and then the next two to be 1FR. And the browser is able to calculate the width of those FR units and make those two columns flexible while keeping that very first column completely set at the fixed width. This is super handy for situations, for example, where maybe you need to have some kind of sidebar with ads according to the IAB specification and they have a fixed size and you need that, you want that column to be fixed and then you want everything else to be fluid. Grid is going to make mixing those two situations together super easy. Here's another example where you can say 50 pixels, 2FR, 1FR, 1FR, min content. We can mix all these things together. So that last column is going to be whatever size it is based on the content that's inside of it. Could be different on different pages. The first column is just going to be, you know, maybe it's empty, just a nice empty column of 50 pixels of nothingness to give us some extra space. And then the others are going to be 2FR, 1FR, 1FR. The FR units don't have to all be 1FR. You can make different sizes. Here, in fact, we have 1FR, 6FR, 2.4FR, 2.4FR, 2FR, and we have a ratio-based array. We can use decimal point numbers. We don't have to even use only integers. You can have any kind of layout that you possibly want. Mark Bolton has been talking about this for a number of years, using ratio-based arrays. For over a decade, he's been encouraging the industry to do designs that are not 12 symmetrical columns, one after another, or even any even number of symmetrical same-sized columns, but to change our layout and use the power of graphic design to enhance a brand or to convey voice and tone. He has a bunch of examples up at gridsetup.com where he's done some ratio-based arrays. This is a web page layout based on the grid and the ratio of the Penguin book cover. You can see here the grid lines that he put together. Or this one. They're really quite beautiful. And none of them are a 12-column symmetrical grid layout. You might not realize it. As a reader, you might just go to this site and assume that it's just a basic grid layout the same way that everybody else has. But it actually looks quite different because he's using columns of different sizes, of different widths. Here's a graphic from an article that Nathan Ford wrote. Nathan used to work for Mark Bolton, and he wrote a whole article about these ideas of what does it mean to take these two layouts that are very, very similar to each other. They're both six-column layouts. One of them has six columns that are all the same size, and the other one has six columns that are different sizes from each other. And it really gives a difference in voice and tone. The one on the right feels different. It feels fresher. It feels kind of new, and like maybe you want to take a moment and look at it, where the one on the left looks more predictable, like you've already been here, you've already seen this. You know, you don't have time for this new stuff. It's not new. You move on. Quick. So link, next link, next link. FR units. They're very powerful. They're very easy to use. It means that we can accomplish things that have been very tough. And it means we can start to wander out into more interesting territory doing better graphic design without a whole lot of complicated pain, but just very simply with FR units and grid.